Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Nos programas offrent plusieurs langues. Veuillez visiter suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Nuestros programas ofrecen varios idiomas. Visite suprememastertv.com/schedule.
برنامه های ما شامل زبان های بسیاری است. از این وبسایت دیدن فرمایید suprememastertv.com/schedule.
No one can be able to really function well in this world, no matter how strong spiritually, if that person continues to open this faculty, psychic power, and hearing all the suffering of the world.
Please keep watching to find out more.
Supreme Master Ching Hai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For free of charge guidance, please visit godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
Today's episode will be presented in Chinese and English, with subtitles in Arabic, Alexis, also known as Vietnamese, Bulgarian, Chinese, Czech, English, French, German, Hindi, Hungarian, Indonesian, Japanese, Korean, Malay, Mongolian, Persian, Polish, Portuguese, Punjabi, Russian, Spanish, Telugu and Thai. Shagotom means welcome in Bengali. Delighted to see you, inspiring viewers. My name is Abani. The caring people of Bangladesh love you and wish you all the comfort that life can offer. At the northeast corner of the Indian subcontinent is South Asia's greenest jewel, Bangladesh, situated between India and Myanmar. It is a country interlaced with rivers and comprises the deltas of the Great Ganges and Brahmaputra rivers, producing fabulously fertile agricultural land and lush landscapes. This land was first settled over 4,000 years ago, while the modern state of Bangladesh dates from 1970. Bangladeshi culture has a rich tradition of singing, often accompanied by instrumental music. Dance is also popular, with music played on many unique instruments, including the single-string dektara, one of the oldest monochord instruments known. There is also a history of rich folk literature dating back to the 8th century AD. This beautiful country's many mosques and Hindu temples speak of the population's spiritual side. The Bangladeshi are courteous and friendly people, and have a famously welcoming attitude, so loved by visitors. It is a privilege to share a glimpse of fascinating Bangladesh with you, wise viewers. We wish your days to be filled with good thoughts and happy moments. For over three decades, Supreme Master Ching Hai has illuminated our world with her divine teachings. A fully enlightened master, she imparts the Kuan Yin method of meditation to those desiring to immediately discover the God nature within, and to achieve in one lifetime eternal liberation from the cycle of transmigration. The Kuan Yin method has been practiced by all enlightened masters, such as the worship world donor one Shakyamuni Buddha, the worship Son of God Jesus Christ, the venerated master and philosopher Confucius, the venerated Lord Krishna, the venerated master and philosopher Lao Tzu, the venerated Lord Mahavira, the beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, the first Sikh Guru Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji, and many more. Supreme Master Qinghai emphasizes that if we always remember God, render selfless service to others, and follow the laws of the universe, we will reach our highest potential as humans and truly understand our purpose on Earth. She is an extraordinary living example of compassion, regularly sending material and financial assistance, as well as love, to refugees, the homeless, natural disaster victims, and others needing relief. Supreme Master Qinghai is deeply grateful to the beloved God for all the financial help, comfort, and support to the afflicted and needy and or any good cause over the years. As a humble vessel for His compassion and love toward His precious children, Supreme Master Qinghai respectfully thank all special individuals, organizations, leaders, and governments for all your genuine, loving, ongoing support. May heaven bless you forevermore. We, the Supreme Master Qinghai International Association members, are also sincerely grateful for your expressive kindness, wishing you the best. Supreme Master Qinghai receives love and recognition from various organizations, media, governments, and individuals, as well as many awards from them, such as the 2006 Guzi Peace Prize, considered the Nobel Peace Prize of the East, the World Spiritual Leadership Award in 1994, the Mahavir Award in 2008, February 22nd and October 25th, both proclaimed as the Supreme Master Qinghai Day, an honorary citizen of the United States, etc., and has been honored throughout the years with numerous other awards and accolades for her outstanding philanthropic and humanitarian deeds. etc.
We apologize for not being able to show many other awards and honors for lack of space and time.
Supreme Master Qinghai respectfully thank all special individuals, organizations, leaders, and governments for all your genuine, loving, ongoing support. May heaven bless you forevermore. We, the Supreme Master Qinghai International Association members, are also sincerely grateful for your expressive kindness, wishing you the best. A true voice for our beautiful animal friends, Supreme Master Qinghai promotes the peaceful and loving plant-based diet and envisions, with humanity's awakening to the sacredness of all life. A tranquil and glorious all-vegan world where animals and people live in blissful harmony. Her initiatives to spread the vegan trend are diverse and have included alternative living flyer distribution, the International Vegan Restaurants Loving Hut, vegan food product companies, vegan fur products, Supreme Master Television, as well as regularly speaking to influential government and media leaders, and participating in televised conferences on climate change, etc. Whether we are aware of it or not, her efforts have had an enormous influence on global awareness of the animal-friendly lifestyle and how this benevolent way can bring lasting peace among nations while saving our planet from climate change and disasters. Over the years, Supreme Master Qinghai has traveled worldwide, from the Americas to Africa, from Europe to Oceania, and held hundreds of discourses with the public and her disciples on a variety of spiritual topics. Today, we are blessed to present one of these insightful lectures entitled The Life of Lord Mahavira, The Great Renunciation, Part 4 of 4, on Between Master and Disciples, given in Chinese and English on June 23, 2019, at the New Land Ashram, Taiwan, also known as Formosa.
His heart was filled with equanimity and compassion. His face beamed with a spontaneous smile. Why does he feel compassion after he has this power? Because he can feel what the humans or beings around him or in the world feel. You know, their sorrow, their pain, their frustration, their troubles, their helplessness. They're suffering. That's why he has compassion for them. The masters, they all have all this. Just sometimes they have to shut it down, otherwise they cannot continue to do their job. The sympathy they have for all beings will collapse them mentally, emotionally, psychically, and bodily as well. No one can be able to really function well in this world, no matter how strong spiritually, if that person continues to open this faculty, psychic power, to and hear in all the suffering of the world. The Kuan Yin Bodhisattva, she hears them, their pleas, only when necessary, only when they are desperate, and only for that person or those persons. She doesn't always have to hear all the suffering in the world, because that will be too much, even for a Buddha. Now, he walked with firm and steady steps towards the jungle without turning around or hesitating. Now he's going away to the jungle to contemplate. Suddenly, there was a feeble call from behind. The call of a pain-filled heart retards the movement of Mahasraman also. because it's so pitiful, a voice calling for help, that he slow his movement. Normally he doesn't want to slow. He wants to go steadfastly to the jungle. But then there is a voice, very weak and pitiful, calling for help behind him, so he slowed down. And then a wiry and weak Brahman, moving briskly with the help of a stick, arrived and fell at the feet of the Mahashraman. Tears were flowing from his eyes, and there was an expressive pain on his pitiable face. He uttered humbly, "O Prince Vardhaman, kindly liberate me. Give me something. Remove my poverty." Shraman Mahavir recognized this old man to be some Shama of Brahmakund. Long back, he used to come to the king Siddhartha's court. The charitable king extended him all help by giving whatever he needed. He was happy then, but he was not seen after the king's death. Some Shama said, "Prince, I wander around from one state to another state after the death of King Siddhartha, my mentor. Wherever I went, my bad luck followed me. After 2 years of wandering in vain, I have returned home this morning. On my return, my family members informed me about your year-long charity. Everyone got what he desired, but I, the ill-fated, got nothing from your charitable hands. Prince, as soon as I reached home, I came to know that abandoning everything, you have become ascetic only today. Prince Vardhaman, please have pity on this poor destitute. Remove my poverty with your kind hands." This is impossible. The prince already renounced everything. He has only one piece of cloth on him. How can any man have a heart to come begging like that? People are really impossible to comprehend. And he's a Brahmin. He has family even. Now he could do something to earn a living. But he just has to bother people like that. Became a monk already, has nothing at all, and still come and bugging. These kind of people. Brahmin supposed to be the most noble class in India at that time, and still in some area now in India. Supposed to be the most learned, the most noble, the one that you cannot even treat unkindly or slander of any kind. They are revered like high priest, yeah? And behave like that. Imagine. Mahavir was filled with compassion, but today he had nothing more to give. Suddenly, he thought of the divine cloth on his shoulder. So he tore it into two parts and gave half to the Brahman. The Brahman was filled with joy. What kind of joy is that? Robbing somebody who is already a monk and who has nothing with him anymore and still feel joyful. Yeah? Being Brahman and all that. So the Brahman took this piece of cloth to a mender and inquired about its value. The mender said, "Brahman, how did you get this divine cloth? It is just a part of a whole. If you could bring me the other part also, I will mend it back into its original form, and you could sell it for 100,000 gold coin." Oh. The greedy Brahman ran back to Mahavir and followed him everywhere he went. Some Brahman, huh? After about a year, the remaining piece of the divine cloth fell one day from Mahavir's shoulder. Some Shama picked it up, got it mended, and sold it to King Nadivadan for 100,000 gold coins. Now, neglecting his body, the venerable ascetic Mahavir meditated just by himself, in blameless lodgings and wandering, in restraint, kindness, avoidance of sinful influence, chaste life, patience, freedom from passion, and contentment, practicing control, circumspectness, religious postures and acts, walking the path of nirvana and liberation, which is the fruit of good conduct. Living thus, he, with equanimity, bore, endure, sustain, and suffer all calamities, arising from divine powers, men and animals, with undisturbed and unafflicted mind, careful of body, speech, and heart. All right. Any question about that? About anything? OK, huh? 今天到这里为止。 那去吃饭的时间，啊，要回家。好东西也不能吃太多，OK？ 我也不能念给你们听那么多，两天已经听很多了，以后再说，下个礼拜好吗？如果在的话，再继续念给你们听，OK？哎，念词还好啦，就怕有时候我。 多余解释很多东西，总会国跑到另外一国，总一个大师跑到另外一个大师，总一个故事跑到另外一个故事，就时间拉得很长啊，怕你们饿坏了，然后巴士跑掉，你们走路回台北，这高雄好长啊，<笑>走到下个月才能回去。OK， 从这边跑到高雄应该多久时间啊？走路。 半个月，那不错嘛，不错，那不能走路算了，留下来嘛。<笑>每天也是很苦啊，吃东西，然后打瞌睡，然后怎么样<笑> ？OK， see you later. Next time. Thank you. <笑>哦，认识了几十年了，还是一样啊。有没有结什么婚啊？哎呀，太好了，好聪明啊！<笑>业障没来找你哈，<笑>你也没有去找他，没有，太好了。喂，怎么都不老呢？奇怪，不可思议，大概打坐多哈，嗯
，very good。
台湾啊，哇哦，蛮你们蛮认真哦，对你们很骄傲，嗯，对不起了，没有对你们什么特别的，就看多几年而已，好吗？嗯，我们是主人啊，不能要求了，是吗？哎呀，应该要送给别人的啊，我们慷慨好客，一起嘛啊，我们一起是这样的。 有时候我也是这样啊，如果东西不多，我自己会送给别人了、啊。东西不多，其实我的东西啊，如果不够的话，我东西会给他们。印度人他们也是这样啊，哎，如果有人来他们的家啊，他们没有多少，也全部贡献出来。他们认为任何人来啊，是的，上帝来，不是上帝派来的。 所以他们对客人呢，跟对上帝一样，很尊重。 就没东西也全部拿出来，你们知道个师傅讲过一个故事，是那个卡比亚那个僧人有没有？卡比亚大师啊，连他太太也想拔出来卖，哎，为了供养那些来拜访他的和尚啊，还有那个过路的人，他们来的话，是客人嘛，哎，还好太太也没卖，东西也拿到，<笑>记得故事吗？ 哦，不错，那你们也不用这样这么过分，好不好？<笑>先生太太要自己保管，OK， 大师不一样啊，他做一些比较不同的事情嘛，所以让那个买卖的人比较怕，嗯，商店那个主人呢、啊，他很喜欢那个高比亚的太太，因为高比亚太太很漂亮，应该。 应该是这样了，然后他常常要他的太太不要，讨厌，<笑>然后就那天呢，戈壁派他太太过去那个商店呢、啊，要跟他借一些面粉呢、啊，为了回来要弄弄杂巴蒂嘛，因为刚好那天很多人来拜访他，大概。 是土地啊，或是牧羊者啊，都有啦。OK， 或是和尚啊，都有。嗯，多数来都是和尚。那些印度的人呢、啊，和尚他们不分别啊，你是在家人、出家人。如果他知道你开悟，他就会来拜访你就对了。嗯，那么不够那个面粉呢、啊，弄杂巴地啦啊，所以他派太太过去接一下，没钱啊。 过去要面粉哪里有啊？然后那个商店的主人就说：“你留下来嘛，<笑>你跟我一个晚上的什么面粉都给你了，不用钱的。”那太太贼讨厌了、啊，就跑回去，<笑>跑回去跟先生说了，先生说：“就这样子而已，你也不肯啊！啊、哦，我带你过去。<笑>”好，他就把太太抱过去啊。 下雨嘛，怕太太弄脏弄湿，怎么抱过去？抱过去说，刚才我太太不懂事啊，对不起啦，现在她是你的，啊，面粉给我。<笑>哇，那个商店吓了一跳，第一哪里有那么慷慨的先生，疯子的先生？事实上，在那个范围，他也大概知道戈壁是开悟的名士啊。 就是他太无名，没有跟着，又要他的太太，那有这样子？隔壁哈，啊，邻居不好哈。不过隔壁是把太太拿出来呀、啊，贡献了啊，面粉还给我就好了。结果那个人吓坏了，因为隔壁这么直啊，那么真诚啊，说他吓了一跳。第二，他们两个为什么在鱼，从他的家跑那边也是一段路啊，下雨这么大，两个都什么都没有。 没有一滴雨在身上啊，所以他怕了。他说：“啊、哦，好了，不敢了，我刚开玩笑而已，哪敢哪敢啊？好，你要多少面粉，全部带走。<笑> ”OK， 嗯，还好我们台湾面粉很多，<笑>不用那一胶哈。<笑> OK， 也不要试看看了、啊，有时候人不那么好的啦 ，OK。 印度人他们不管怎么样，无名怎么样，也知道修行的人，懂不懂？也是要尊重，也知道有这种修行人的力量，还有尊重，懂不懂？嗯，别的地方我不保证哦，哦，不要乱吃看看哦。嗯，<笑>太太跑掉，别怪我哦。<笑>哎，真的哪有这种先生哈？连太太也卖掉。 为了请客了，啊，为了请客，你们会不会跟护法剃度啊？不会，我需要他们那些肌肉啊，懂吗？因为我都是看人嘛，有时候路不平啊，有时候会跌倒，他们再扶一扶也好。嗯，有当过兵比较有那种警觉性啊，懂吗？女孩子没有当过兵，男孩子都有，是有用了。OK。 有时候我都看你们没有看路嘛，然后走路有时候不方便。 Thank you 行。
Gentle viewers, we appreciate your company for today's episode entitled The Life of Lord Mahavira, The Great Renunciation, Part 4 of 4, on Between Master and Disciples. Coming up next is from Alice Bailey's The Reappearance of the Christ, The Doctrine of the Coming One, Part 2 of 3, on Words of Wisdom, right after Noteworthy News. Please stay tuned to Supreme Master Television for more positive programming. May love and laughter light your days and warm your hearts.
Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule and suprememastertv.com/BMD.